Hey everybody, welcome to Beaver Does Productions, back again with another daily movie review. The daily movie reviews are from May 2021 to May 2022. For the entire year, I am going to be doing a movie a day. And by that, I'm doing a movie review a day. And by movies, I mean anything from brand new, you know, stuff I've never seen before, short films, or even stuff that you guys recommend to me. Now, let's get into it. We are back again with Japan Week. Yes, of course. And we are back with the third Evangelion movie, Evangelion 3.33, You Cannot Redo. Evangelion 3.33 You Cannot Redo on Amazon Prime is a animation, is the third in the Rebuild series, where it takes the original Evangelion series and reimagines it. And the first two were pretty much, as you would say, almost the same. Like, there is a little bit of changes in the first one, more in the second one, whereas this, we're in like brand new territory with a small smattering from the original series. And the new story territory, So the third impact has happened. And what that means is that the world is pretty much in a lot worse than it was before. And previously from the second impact, all animal life was pretty much almost extinct. You know, they actually brought it up in the second one, which I forgot to bring up, that 90% of the world's meat protein source is like Beyond Meat and stuff like that. And this is now post-apocalyptic now. And we are now, by the way, spoiler alert for this movie, skip ahead if you don't want to. Make sure you check out Billy Blanks' face, and that will be where I get to the point. Now, so with the third impact happening, what has happened now is we are now 14 years into the future. Shinji has been sleeping for the entire time, and he is suddenly rescued by Oscar and Mari. And it turns out that he is not grown in any way. Same with Oscar, same with Mari. Rei is another reason. When I saw that, I kind of groaned, because I know with the way Oscar and Shinji and Rei look, to age them up, it will like kind of take, it's kind of taken away the one of the main selling points, which is those characters. Their images on so much different merchandise, for them to have changed it up in any way, like drastically. I think they kind of had to bring this in just to keep them around as children. And I didn't like it. I do hope that in the fourth one explains what is happening to their bodies and why they're technically eternally, like, I think they're 14. But I did enjoy this time skip though, because everyone else is completely different. We've got some cool, radical new designs for characters. I really like what they did with Masato. Masato is very interesting in what they put with her, in that she's now the leader of a anti-nerve group called Wheel or whatever stuff. And they are now running, they have their own ship, which is using the remains of Ava Unit 1. And from there, Shinji, the cool thing I did like was that we were pretty much with Shinji throughout. We're learning as Shinji learns, and I did like that they did that. I did really enjoy that they brought it in, and you kind of go with him as he goes and discovers all the different things. Like, he ends up going to Nerve, meeting Karu, and the way that they did their relationship, I really did like it. It slowly starts where you can just see Karu actually really cares for Shinji and stuff like that. And it develops, and they also introduce a new Ava who kind of looks like Unit 1, but it's called Unit 13. And pretty much the intention is they want to they want to evolve humans again. And that is Shinji's father's ultimate plan, is to use this to grab some spears and re-evolve humanity. And it's up to the anti-nerve to stop it. And I really like the battles, like the first battle in space is amazing. Really, and the thing I do enjoy is it doesn't like become a congealed mess of colors. You can tell who Unit 2 is. You can tell who, I think it's Unit 6 is, and Unit, you know, the new Unit 0. You can tell who is fighting who. It's not just a disgusting mess of, you know, color. You can tell what's going on, and they really do put it well together. Some problems I do have with it. I do feel like I enjoyed this. I really did, but I don't think this works as a standalone release. I am so glad I waited for the whole series to be out before I check this out, because there's a huge gap from this, which came out in 2014 in Canada, and just in 2021 the new one has been released. So I'm kind of glad I waited. And if you are like me and you use my review to maybe see if you want to check this out, definitely watch this all in a row. Also, in my opinion, it kind of feels like they're just retreading steps with a different coat of paint, because this ends the way the second one ended, that we get another impact. So it ends with a fourth impact, and we're wondering what the hell is going on. And I just, it feels like, other than the whole Shinji Ikari and the Carol stuff and some revelations and stuff like that, I feel like they could have done this in half an hour. This could have been tacked on to another movie, and that would have been fine. But it is what it is. I did enjoy what they brought. Issues aside, it's still a really, really strong movie. I really did enjoy it. I'm definitely wanting to, in a non-reviewer sense, wanting to check the whole series out again. Although it all depends on the fourth one. Yeah, does the fourth one ruin it for me? So as for my review, I've been giving it 4 across the board, and it's still going strong. There's been no waning of quality from this. So this is a 4 blanks movie. It's very strong. It takes it into new places that have not been seen before. And even though it kind of ends the way the previous one did, I still enjoyed it. And the visuals are just breathtaking. It's really, really good looking. So tomorrow, it is time. It is the end of Evangelion. If you've been watching this series, or if you've seen the series, definitely throw a like, comment what your thoughts are on it, and don't forget to subscribe, because Japan Week is continuing. Later, guys, and be safe.